But guys, he's not the first skater to be labeled an athlete, not an artist. How do you go about changing that?
It's all about choosing music that's effective, that people know, that goes with your skating. We look at skaters like Elvis Stoiko, Brian Joubert, who chose music that was effective for them and their style.
He represents the Broadmoor Skating Club of Colorado Springs, Colorado. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Max Aaron.
Does know how to get to the top step of the podium. He did it, as we said, back in 2013. The next year, he was the bronze medalist. Last year, a disappointing fourth in Greensboro. One Skate America to start the year, that first event in the Grand Prix Series. International skating at the highest level during the regular season. He was terrific. Two quads in his free skate there. We'll see what he brings on the ice here in St. Paul.
With Jason Brown out of the competition and the way that the judges have judged Nathan Chen tonight, it is very apparent that this is his title to lose. And it seems the pressure has been weighing on him all week, very inconsistent on his quads in practice. And here it is, the big money maker, Quad Sal. Beautiful triple toe. Big triple axel right here.
Triplets to end the jumps of this short program.
If he's not balletic enough for you, that is fine. But that was a powerful, entertaining, incredibly difficult, technically crazy amazing performance. That's how excited I am.
It was a great, great performance.
It was
solid from top to bottom, but there still were those moments when you wanted him to be flying around the ice and hitting every accent. But still,
he's
really got a nitpick.
But he's the best of the best that is here tonight. That is very clear with that program.
A lot of people standing here in XL Energy Center thinking, why do you have to label anything? It is what I just saw on the ice, and it's pretty darn good. Max Aaron, the 23-year-old from Scottsdale, Arizona, skated in this building back in 2008, part of the junior championships. It was shortly after that he decided to give up hockey and become a full-time figure skater. And let's be clear, he was a top-level hockey player at the national level, as a matter of fact. Competed against a number of guys who are now in the NHL, and at least one who plays in this building.
His jumps are so clean, so technically perfect. Watch this quad. Sal gets such great height, has plenty of time in the air, has so much flow going out of a difficult combination like that.
That quad is what I remember people talking about, Viktor Petrenko's triple axel just flying across the whole end of the rink. This is Max's triple axel. Very well done. A little teeny bobble there on the end because he let his left arm go. You've got to check and not lose your focus.
And here was his last jumping pass, the triple Lutz. This is probably like a single axel to him. It's just so easy.
It was a fabulous performance. It really was a great step in the right direction. He got all of us to get behind him and believe him with that music. And that's part of being an artist.
Papa, Kersman, Strikers, Mason, Haley, and Cindy.
We like
Jerry. So Ross Miner, the current leader, over 90 points. Terrific for the man who's gotten so close so many times, but has never gotten to the top step. We check out the number. And Max Aaron, 91.83, the fourth highest score ever at the U.S. Championships in the short.
I'm a bit shocked he's only 1 point ahead of Ross Miner, who had a much easier performance.